To describe the situation in Bahrain right now as an ongoing campaign against press freedom would be inaccurate. Rather, what we've seen is a successfully carried out campaign with the judiciary and with a lack of action from the international community that has successfully silenced most remaining independent voices in journalism. Of course, the Bahrain authorities' crackdown against journalists and against freedom of the press has been part of a larger campaign against freedom of expression in the wake of the uprisings that began in February 2011. That year, we saw two journalists who were killed, both in the custody of the authorities, Zakaria Al-Ashiri and Karim Fakhraoui. Fakhraoui was also a reporter for Al-Wasat, which had already established a reputation for being a thorn in the authorities' side. He died in police custody April 12th, a week after Al-Ashiri. Authorities told his family that he died of kidney failure, yet his body was returned to his family bearing very clear signs of torture. The next year, photographer Ahmed Hassan was shot while covering a protest. The protest had already been dispersed, but an unmarked Land Cruiser pulled up and started firing upon the protesters and also Hassan. We've seen a situation there where the judiciary, which has very effectively prosecuted human rights activists and journalists, has so far not launched any credible investigation into his death and to investigating who's responsible. In addition to the killings that we recorded, CPJ has documented at least six journalists behind bars in Bahrain as of December 1st, 2017. I spoke of Mahmoud Al-Jaziri and Ali Miraj. It is worth reporting that both of them are in jail on charges of belonging to a terrorist cell. This is a very, very clear sign of the use and weaponization of counterterrorism rhetoric, if not actual actions, against journalists. We can also speak about the case of Ahmed Humaydan, who was sentenced to 10 years in prison March 2014 because he was covering protesters' attack against a police station. Of course, the authorities charged him and convicted him of participating in that attack. Last year, as we were doing our research, we learned that Ahmed Humaydan had been denied family visits in jail prison for at least 7 months. This is a tactic that other speakers on this panel refer to as well. We also learned that he developed a severe eye infection in prison, which the clinic was not equipped to treat. Authorities have refused repeated requests for him to be transferred for the necessary treatment, and as a result, he is in danger of losing his vision permanently. Given that, it seems unbelievable that the situation for journalists in Bahrain could deteriorate further, and in fact it has. Last year, I alluded to the court order